Sticking to the deadline, the army has successfully completed the construction of the FOB at Elphinstone. Chief Minister Fadnavis had earlier promised a deadline of 31st of January. Now, just to remind the viewers here that the rush hour stampede at Mumbai's Elphinstone station killed 23 people last year. Aishwarya joining us with further details. She's standing by at that very footover bridge that's been newly constructed by the Indian Army. Aishwarya, it is the day for the Army now there to gloat about the fact that they have finished this construction of this bridge on time, in fact, before time. What are the particular challenges that the Army says that it faced while the construction of the bridge?
Well, the first thing that the army says one of the major challenges was the coordination between the railway department and the army. What Brigadier Dheeraj Mohan said just a few minutes before was that he said that both of these are humongous organizations and the coordination took a lot of time. Now I'll ask my camera person to pan and he'll be able to show you how this is the new footover bridge. Now by tonight they'll be able to put all the pieces together, and that is how they have launched this bridge. Now this bridge would be 12 feet wide and it is 240 foot long. Now this is an additional bridge which will give people who use Elphinstone station on a daily basis an option to choose, because of which in the end there won't be a lot of pressure on the existing footover bridges. Now they are saying that they'll throw open this new footover bridge by the 15th of February for the citizens. Now the other two footover bridges being built by the army were one in Curry Road, which will be opened by the 4th of Feb, and the Ambivali one has already been opened. The army claims that any heavy vehicle can cross over on this bridge, which means that no matter how many citizens use this bridge, nothing will happen. So now that's a good sign for the citizens of Mumbai who use Elphinstone station very regularly, because as you can see behind, there are a lot of buildings here in Lower Parel in Elphinstone, because a lot of offices are based here. So Elphinstone from that point of view is a very crucial station.
Right. Right, so it will be thrown up for public use in a few days from now, Aishwarya. But we also understand in the media interaction that the army did a short while back, the army also mentioned that there were a lot of challenges, and first challenge there being the coordination between railways and the army. Did they also mention on whether any sort of help was extended to them by the railways? Was it a sole work of the army, or was there any coordination with the railways as well? What kind of inputs did they get from the Indian Railways Ministry?
Well, there was a lot of coordination between these two departments, but if you ask for help, the help that army got from the railway department was that as and when the army requested for the trains to stop, they did get that support from the railways. But if you ask about any kind of help in the on the construction front, then this is 100% work of the army, from soil testing to floating tenders to construction to getting these bridges here in Mumbai. Everything has been done by army, and these bridge that you see behind me, these green colored constructions, they are actually from a place which is close to Doklam. So the army is saying that this is their work, 100% their work. The coordination from the coordination between these two departments, the army and the railways, was definitely a challenge. It took them few days to overcome the challenge, but apart from that, smooth functioning from the railways and from the army.
And the questions we understand were raised on why is it that the Indian Army had to be called in, because it implied in many ways a failure of state and civic bodies, because the civic bodies were supposed to upgrade the infrastructure, but in a scenario like this that we saw playing out, claiming 23 lives due to the collapse of Elphinstone Bridge, we saw the Railways Minister there thinking of getting in the army there to building this bridge. Of course, the Indian Army there doing a commendable job and finishing the construction of the bridge in time, well before time there, Aishwarya. But there was massive criticism as well when this move was taken.
Well, there was a lot of criticism because many of the citizens were questioning, why do you need the army to step in? This is the work of the state government. The state government should step in. Your railway department should step in. Your municipality should step in. Why is army being called? Now, once we overlook all these things, what the army says is that they were ready to help the the people of Mumbai. They said that this is a part of nation building, and from that point of view, the army said that you know, they did not have any kind of problem in doing this work. However, they said that because they wanted this work to be done by them, that's the reason why 100% of the work army overtook, from soil testing to to bringing these bridges here and to the final construction, everything was finally done by the army. A lot of criticism there, but I believe in the end of the day, a good step for the citizens of Mumbai, because now an additional footover bridge will be open in the next 15 days for the citizens of Mumbai, and they'll have an option to choose from which bridge they want to travel.
All right, Aishwarya Paliwal, many thanks for getting us those inputs on that story.